Hello students, now I am going to teach you second part of our last lesson, the kingdom fools of in the kingdom of fools. So open the page number 23. I am reading the paragraph. The goldsmith named the merchant, and he was none other than the original owner of the house whose wall had fallen. Now king asked him, who was the merchant, that rich person, rich man, because of him you didn't make this poor girl's jewelry? So he named the person. Who was that man? Who was none other than that man who in whose house that wall had fallen. Now justice had come full circle. Full circle means from where it started, it is ending here only. Thought the king back to the merchant. When he was rudely summoned back to the court, he arrived crying, "It wasn't me, but my father who ordered the jewelry. He's dead. I'm innocent." And he said, "Yes, you're right, but it was not me. It was my father who did this. Who ordered the jewelry? Now what should I do? He is no more now. He is dead." But the king consulted his minister and ruled decisively. Decisively means, see the meaning, in a way that shows the ability to make decision quickly and effectively. So he was acting like he is decisively. He is taking the decisions at his own and doing that. "It's true your father is a true murderer. He is dead, but somebody must be punished in this place. You have inherited everything from that criminal father of yours." And he said, "Yes, it is right, you are true, but it should be punished. Someone should be punished, somebody should be punished. And you are inherited means you are taken heriting all the things from our past generation. So like you inherited all the money, all the things from your father, like that you have to inherited all these things also, his riches as well as his sins." Sins means pap, whatever they did of sins, you have to face that. "I knew at once, even when I first set eyes on you, that you were at the root of these horrible crime. You must die." And he said, "Yes, I know that from already when I saw you, and now you should be punished. It is a crime." And he ordered a new stake to be made ready for the execution. See the meaning of stake? A post with a sharp pointed end used to post through, means it is one long one stick that should fall, we used to kill the person. As the servants sharpened the stake and got it ready for the final impaling of the criminal, impaling means to push a sharp pointed paste through something, it occurred to the minister that the rich merchant was somehow too thin to be properly executed on the stake. So it means that they got ready all the things, they were doing all the things to make ready that execution, but what they saw, that the person, that the rich merchant is very thin, so they cannot do that, they cannot execute, they cannot do that stake and in his body. He appealed to king's common sense, the king too worried about it. "What shall we do?" he said, when suddenly it struck him that all they needed to do was to find a man fat enough to feed the stake. So now see this is the, you can say this is the end point of the story, or this is the foolishness of fool, foolishness of that king who is thinking somebody should be punished, and that is why, and because that merchant is too thin, he cannot fit in that stake, he is so thin, so now he is saying that you must see something, or you must find some person, some man who must be fat so he can fit in that stake. This is the foolishness. The servants were immediately sent all over the town looking for a man who would fit the stake. And their eyes fell on the disciple who had fattened himself for months on bananas and rice and wheat and ghee. And then his servants went to the market and they were roaming, they were finding a fat man. Then they saw this fat man, who the disciple who came with his guru at once, and his guru left him and disciple was there only. He don't want to leave that city because there was everything at very cheap rate. So he was now very fat by eating bananas, rice, wheat, ghee. "What have I done wrong? I am innocent. I am sannyasi," he cried, and he was very crying. He was, and he is saying, "Arey, I am not any criminal. I am a very innocent person. I am a sannyasi. What have I done wrong?" "That may be true, but it's the royal decree that we should find a man fat enough to feed the stake." Decree means order. This is they say, yes, it is true, you are right, but we have to, it is just order that we have to find out the fat man who will fit in the stake, they said, and carried him to the place of execution. He remembered his wise guru's words. "This is a city of fools. You don't know what they will do next." While he was waiting for death, he prayed to his guru in his heart, asking him to hear his cry wherever he was. And then he remembered his guru's wise words that, yes, he said on that day, "You should leave this place, or you know what they will do with you, because they all are fool." But in his mind, he was praying to his guru and he is asking help from him in his mind. The guru saw everything in a vision. He had magic powers. He could see far, and he could see the future as he could see the present and the past. So guru, he is a big person, right? So he is a very wise man. He can see the vision of future, of past, of anything, from anywhere. He arrived at once to save his disciple who had got himself into such a scrap through love of food. Scrap means it is a very difficult situation, a difficult situation that one has got into. Because of his foolishness, he was there because of the food. He was getting food on very cheap rate, and that is why he was there. And he scrapped there, means in a difficult situation. As soon as he arrived, he scolded the disciple and told him something in a whisper. Then he went to the king and addressed him, "Oh, wisest of kings, who is greater, the guru or the disciple?" Then that guru has arrived there and he scolded him. First of all, scolded the disciple. "I told you, no, I already told you that they will do anything with you. You have no idea, but you are just fool." And then he just whispered in his eye, in his ears, and he went to the king. And now he is asking, "Who is the greater? Tell me, disciple or guru? Guru or disciple?" "Of course, the guru." No doubt about it. Why do you ask? Now king said, yes, of course, the guru is the greater all the time. There is no any doubt about it. But why are you asking this? Then put me to the stake first. Put my disciple to death after me. Then he said, then now first put me to that stake and after that my disciple. When the disciple heard this, he understood and began to clamor. Clamor means a loud and confused noise, especially that of people shouting. So he understood what is going on, because Guru already whispered in his ears. So he clamored, means he was making loud voices. Me first, he said, yes, first me, but you brought me here first, put me to the death first, not him. And he said, no, not that Guru, first me, you have to first put me to that stake, after that my Guru. The Guru and the disciple now got into a fight about who should go first. The king was puzzled by this behavior. He asked the Guru, why do you want to die? We chose him because we needed a fat man for us for the stake. Then he said that king got confused, got puzzled, why they are fighting to die. Then he asked to that Guru, why you want to die? That man is here because he is very fat. I want a fat who will fit to this stake. You shouldn't ask me such questions. Put me to the death first, replied the Guru. He said, you should not ask me some like these questions. You have to put me first to that stake. Why? There's some mystery here. As a wise man, you must make me understand. He said, why? Is there any mystery? Is there any rahasya? So if there, then you should make me understand. Will you promise to me to put me to death if I tell you? Asked the Guru. The king gave him his solemn word. Solemn means formal and dignified. So the Guru took him aside out of the servant's earshot and whispered to him, do you know why we want to die right now, the two of us? Then he asked, yes, he gave him promise, yes, I will make you death if you will tell me that mystery. Then that Guru took him aside of the servants and he started whispering in his ears that, do you know why we want to die right now, the two of us? We have been all over the world, but we have never found a city like this or a king like you. That stake is the stake of the God of justice. And he said, we have roamed all over the world, but we have never seen the city like this. We have never met the king like you. And this stake is the stake of justice. This is the justice of a God. It's new. It has never had a criminal on it. Whoever dies on it first will be the reborn as the king of this country. And whoever goes next will be the future minister of this country. We are sick of our eccentric life. Eccentric means life of a very sannyasi. It would be nice to enjoy ourselves as king and minister for a while. Now keep your word, my lord, and put us to death. Me first, remember. And he said, what he said? If I will get died in this wonderful city, then I will reborn as a king. And who is putting death after me, he will reborn as my minister. So I want to become a king in my next born. And he will become a minister. So now just do your best. And I am just very fed of this sannyasi life. I want to just get rid of this. So now first me, remember na? The king was now thrown into a deep thought. He didn't want to lose the kingdom to someone else in the next round of life. He needed time. So he ordered the execution postponed to the next day and talked in secret with his minister. Then he got very deep thought. Why? I only want this kingdom in my next life also. So he postponed that execution. Postponed means it will be on next day or next another day. So he secretly called his minister. It's not right for us to give over the kingdom to others in the next life. Let's go on the stake ourselves and we will be reborn as a king and minister again. Holy men, do not tell lies, he said, and the minister agreed. So now he convinced that his minister also that why should we leave this kingdom for anyone else in our next born also, in our next generation also, next round of life also. So he got convinced, okay, and he said, this holy man, this sant, this guru will never lie. So his minister got agreed. So he told the executioners, we will send the criminals tonight. When the first man comes to you, put him to death first. Then do the same to the second man. Those are my orders. Don't make any mistake. Then he told that executioners that you should punish that criminals. The first man will be who comes to you. He should be dead first, and after that, the person who is coming, he should be dead. Don't make any mistakes. That night, the king and his minister went secretly to the prison, released the guru and the disciple, disguised themselves as the two. Disguised means a different appearance in order to conceal one's identity. Means you have to hide your identity. And as arranged beforehand, with loyal servants were taken to the stake and promptly executed. Then they went secretly to that prison, they released that guru and disciple, and after that they disguised themselves, means they hide themselves, and they, or you can say, taken another costume they were, and they went to the execution and they get executed, they get dead. Now, when the bodies were taken down to the throne, to crows and vultures, and the people panicked. They saw before them the dead bodies of the king and minister. The city was in confusion. And then their bodies, when it's thrown to the crows and vultures, the people panicked. They got panicked. What is happening here? That guru and that disciple should be punished. Then why our king and minister is here now? What should we do? They got very confused. All night they mourned and discussed the future of the kingdom. Some people suddenly thought of the guru and the disciple and caught up with them as they were preparing to leave town unnoticed. Now they got they were just murmuring that what should we do now? Who will our king, our minister? What should we do? Then after some time, they remember that guru and disciple. So they think they should go to that guru. But here the guru and the disciple were preparing to leave that kingdom. We people need a king and minister, said someone. Others agree. They beg and guru and disciple to be their king and their minister. And all the people went to the guru and they asked him, we need king and minister. So now you should become our king and minister. They were making him convince. It didn't take many arguments to persuade the disciple. But it took longer to persuade the guru. Persuade means convince. It means it may go a long time to convince him, to convince the guru. The disciple got ready after some time, but it was very hard to make him understand or convince. But after some time, he got ready. Guru also got ready. Finally, they agreed to rule the kingdom of the foolish king and the silly minister on the condition that they could change all the old laws. So finally he got ready, because he finally agreed them that the all these old laws will get changed. From then on, night would again be night and day would again be day, and you could get nothing for a dudu. It became like any other place. So now it became like a normal city, like all other are doing. It started like that. So it is, there is day like a day and there is night like a night only. You have to sleep at night, you have to work at day only, and you will not get any for any dudu, and you have to like another place, all another place also it does like this. So it is a Kannada folk tale from A.K. Ramanujan's Folk Tales from India. Now folk tale means it is a story which is passing from one generation to another. So it is a very old story which is passing maybe from very long and last generation. So I hope you understand this. We will meet in next video. Thank you.